It's a research background, and as you know, researchers are always drafting a lot of papers and need many pages. We needed only 200, so, but you are invited to go to this. Here I give a flavor of what we try to describe in this book. We try to analyze our situation, detail the vision for the different components of our system, infrastructure, vehicles, ITS, education, regulation and law enforcement, and we try to specify our approach for these special issues. And last but not least, we paid a lot of attention to implementation, because implementation is crucial for all these nice thoughts. If it's not leading to anything, I'm not satisfied. Perhaps too detailed, but we translated our vision in principles. In principles of redesigning our system, has to do with traffic planning and engineering, has to do with speed management, has to do with human behavior and make the road use more predictable, has to do with how aware you are of the state you are driving and trying to be more forgiving in the environment and in the other road users. I'm not going to detail that now, but we translate this general vision in principles. And I summarize here for you the main characteristics. Don't read it all, but it's ethical. We try to be proactive in our approach. Not to wait until you have crashes and then act. We try to be proactive. We try to be integral. Try to cover all aspects you can think about. We are not just interested in enforcement, not just interested in engineering, education. We try to be integral. We try to reach out to other policy areas, not stand on ourselves on our own, but see how we can use other policy areas as well for our purpose. Man is the measure of everything. We started from the physical vulnerability, we started from the cognitive aspects of the human being. You're reducing latent errors, think about the holes in the screens at the left-hand side of that screen, and the economical criterion we use here is make it cost beneficial for society. You cannot invest everywhere, you cannot invest all the time, make it cost beneficial. These are the main characteristics. You have it? I move on. So we implemented a lot. We implemented a lot. And we started mid-90s, and we had before that a reduction of the number of fatalities of 1.8%. When we implemented these type of thoughts, we increased our fatality reduction to 5.3%. Here we have the actual development until 1988, and then we have predicted what should be the result without this implementation of that package of measures. And here you have the actual development, and you can understand in between we have the results of our work. 300 to 400 deaths a year less. We had 1,000 deaths when we started a year, and due to implementation of this way of thinking, it was a 30 to 40% reduction. And massive investments, 500 million euro a year. And perhaps people are in this room dealing with money saying, well, it's impossible here. You cannot think about that. Please be mind that the majority of this money was no new money, was existing money. We tried to redirect a little bit, add a safety dividend on existing investments. And that's the big challenge here as well. How we can invest in the system without asking for new money, because then you don't make yourself very popular, but try to redirect existing budgets. Economists love this type of statements. However, I have to say, and here we have a challenge. We were very successful in fatalities, but not that successful in injuries, and we have to rethink about that. So that's, I have to confess, here we have to work hard to do our next steps. Coming then to the strategy, and then I come the last few ones, and then I finalize the strategy. It's important to understand that a strategy is more than the first years of an action plan. Sometimes people think it's simply the first years of an action plan. That's not the case. We had these different steps: vision, targets, targeted programs, implementation, evaluation. Very logical, but we needed something like that vision. It's not just an action plan, because in these action plans you can draft beautiful action plans, but you need a supportive political environment. You need effective delivery mechanisms, all your nice ideas, integration, innovation, and quality, investing in quality and knowledge. So if you draft a new strategy, please pay attention to these four bullet points as well, because a book on its own is not very effective. I said, more and more, we in road safety have to look for connections with other fields. Land use planning and transportation planning, compact and efficient urban form, something I've read here as well, very important, giving the opportunities for public transport and cycling. And if you go along that, you have to make that safe. Infrastructure investment, public health, transport and environment, policy for an aging society, all areas, when you have policies over there, you can contribute and use that as well for road safety purposes. My colleague in Sweden said it like this: a vision, if you have a vision, you can share a vision, you cannot share an action plan. And in Sweden, it generated energy, momentum, and his statement was, we could never do that, done that without that vision. Here you have again my objectives, and then I come to my last one. The lessons I learned in the world. Please have a discussion on the need for a paradigm shift based on the sound problem analysis here in South Australia. If you believe you need it, then you can make it perhaps. If you don't agree on that, perhaps it's not wise to do that. Get a strategy with everybody behind. Set ambitious and realistic targets and monitor progress. Raise public awareness and create support in society. It's very important indeed that we have support in society for all the ideas we have, and organize effective and efficient mechanisms with all stakeholders. Political commitment and champions are key to this. Otherwise, you cannot come to any success. So you need it, and you have to work on that. This is really my last one. I would like to get a good understanding of the causes of crashes in South Australia and discuss these results with the professionals and the community. Better fuel the road safety problems in Greater Adelaide and the regional areas. I try to understand why you made progress in the past. What did you do to drive down the road toll? And which are the reasons behind that success? And raise awareness of the road safety problem. Explore leadership. Identify key stakeholders and their roles. Promote public understanding. Discover connections. And explore nudging. These are my elements I would like to address in the future during my residency. This is clear. You can simply duplicate or replicate or copy what we have done, but hopefully my residency will inspire you on this. And this is a speed camera in the Netherlands, and somebody who was trapped by this camera wrote revenge. Don't do that, please. Thank you for your attention.